Hi friends, welcome you all to my YouTube channel. Today I am going to discuss the topic holistic curriculum. Now let us see what are the different aspects of a holistic approach to curriculum. First of all, let us see a definition. Holistic education is a philosophy of education based on the premises that each person find identity, meaning and purpose in line through connections to the community, to the natural world and to humanitarian values such as compassion and peace. So that's a definition for holistic education. It has a philosophy of education based on uniqueness of individuals such as identity, meaning and purpose in life of a person in connection with other members in the community in a natural way, as well as by keeping humanitarian values such as compassion and peace. So this is a definition. So let us see the meaning of holistic education in detail. Holistic education is a relatively new movement in education that seeks to engage all aspects of the learner, including mind, body, and spirit. So that holistic, the term holistic stands for as a whole, whole of the organism, whole of the individual, as we said, all-round development of the personality as an aim of education. Similarly, the holistic education is meant to the whole individual, not only his or her cognition, but mind, body and spirit. Such kind of a system of education, such approach to education is holistic education. The term holistic education is most often used to refer the more democratic and humanistic type of alternate education. So there are various forms of alternative education, and among such type of alternative education, the holistic education is the most democratic and humanistic type of education. Education with a holistic perspective is concerned with the development of every person's intellectual, emotional, social, physical, artistic, creative and spiritual potentials. So as we already said, it is holistic. Consider the person as a whole, means all his diverse capacities, his or her diverse capacities such as intellectual, emotional, social, physical, artistic, creative, spiritual, whatever it is, what all potentialities, capacities, abilities are there for an individual, that should be considered. The development of each of such capacities are meant to be developed properly through holistic education. So let us see some basic assumptions of holistic education. So we already seen that holistic education meant for the individual as a whole, all facets of his potentialities. So it seeks to educate the whole person. There are some of the key factors that is essential to address. So our task is to educate the individual as a whole, his all potentialities, capacities of the learner. So naturally, this type of this approach to that holistic approach to education propose certain basic questions on what children need to learn about. So that's the basic platform. We have to find out answers to certain specific questions as we plan to develop the learner as a whole in all capacities of the learner. So what the children need to learn about themselves, that's first question. What the children need to learn about themselves, then what children need to learn about relationships, what children need to learn about resilience, and what children need to learn about aesthetics. So there are four basic questions regarding what a learner need to learn in the background of holistic approach to education. So what they need to learn about themselves is the first question. So which involves learning self-respect and self-esteem. So the answer of who am I by an individual, that what actually a learner is, that's the first question he or she should know about them. They learn to respect themselves. They need to develop self-esteem. And the second question, or the second aspect, basic assumption on the basis of the question, what children need to learn about relationships. So the second basic important aspect is that the learner should know about relationship. The relationship is highly significant in this approach to curriculum, this holistic approach to curriculum that we already seen in the definition, that identity of the self as well as relation to the community. So similar, the relationships is important. In learning about their relationship with others, there is a focus on learning to see social influence and one's own self in relation to others. So the relation, what is the nature of how to establish relation between the members in the community? That's very significant, as all human beings are social in nature. So it is very essential to establish a healthy relation and a contributory partner to the society. So the second question is what the learner need to learn about relations, how to build up and sustain relation for the welfare of the community as a whole, society as a whole. And the third aspect, resilience. So what the children need to learn about resilience. So this is for overcoming difficulties or helping or facing challenges and learning how to ensure long-term success. So the question about resilience is essential for a learner for overcoming difficulties and enable them to face challenges and help them to learn how to ensure long-term success. So that's the fourth question. And regarding aesthetics, fourth question is regarding aesthetics. This encourages the student to see the beauty of what is in and around them and learn to have awe in life. So that appreciation, that is very essential. So we are already seeing that we are social beings, and a community relationship is essential, and a learner has to find out beauty in things around them in the community. So these are the four basic questions on which holistic education develops, such as the learner's identity, who is the learner, and the relationship of learner with the members in the community, the capacity of resilience, and development of appreciation. And regarding curriculum, when we look into a holistic curriculum, in holistic education, the basic three R's, you know, reading, reckoning, and arithmetic, And here for holistic education, the three R's are relationships, responsibility, and reverence for all life. So these are the three R's: relationships, responsibility, and reverence. So keeping, establishing, and sustaining relations. So that's the first R. So learner is not a loner, a member of the community, so has to establish and sustain relationships. That should be the first R. Then there should be a learner responsibility. Learner is not a passive person. Learner need to interact with other members in the group, other members in the society, or with the learning material. So learner is not passive. Learner has some sort of responsibility. So that capacity shall be developed. That is the second R. And reverence for all life. And the attitude of learner towards life. That's the third R. So these are the three R's. As a basis of acquisition of these three R's, it's a basis for a holistic curriculum. Then curriculum is derived from the teacher listening to each child and helping the child bring out what lies within oneself. So that's a very important consideration about a holistic curriculum, that usually in many curriculum teachers are formulating, designing, or other curriculum developers designing something for the child. Diametrically opposite to that, here the teacher listened to individual learner, individual child, and helped them to bring out the best from them. What capacities are inherent in the learners? So through the curriculum, the holistic approach pointed out to bring out the best in learners. What is inherent in them? So to drawing out the best in them, so that's the duty of the teacher. So in that way, that's the way the curriculum should be developed. Learn to develop problem solving and critical thinking skills. So the curriculum focus on developing the capacity of problem solving as well as critical thinking. And the curriculum should also continually provide opportunities for group work and the development of social skills. So more emphasis should be on group works, not on individual work, and individual development will occur naturally in a group setting. So there shall be regular opportunities in curriculum for managing group work. So that is the aspects of curriculum. And now let us see various strategies proposed in the curriculum in line of a holistic point of view. The first consideration about strategies, teaching learning strategies, is that the idea of holism advocates a transformative approach to learning. So that's the basic consideration regarding learning strategy: a transformative approach to learning, not a traditional one. So in traditional one, we are adopting various strategies, or a teacher is going to lecture on certain topics and students are supposed to be listening to that. So novel ways of, new ways of, or the ways interesting, attractive to learners, that should be the nature of approach to learning. That it should be transformative. Then various aspects of life and living as integrated and connected. So in while selecting strategies or adopting strategies, those are directly integrated or connected to life, daily life of the learner shall be selected. Therefore, education should not isolate learning into several different components. So, the holistic approach believe in holistic learning. So, not compartmentalized learning such as different subjects. They believe in integration, integrated, interconnected learning material as well as learning learning resources, learning experience, etc. Not for fragmented learning as various subjects. This is this subject, this is this subject, such as. So the strategies are in such a way that it integrate the whole and which is go along with life of the learner. And another aspect is transdisciplinary approach involves multiple disciplines and the space between the disciplines with the possibility of new perspectives beyond these disciplines. So that's another approach to strategies learning according to the holistic approach. A transdisciplinary approaches are suggested. So across the discipline, without considering the boundaries of the discipline or the limitations of the disciplines or the space between different disciplines, that shall be properly integrated while adopting strategies. That's another consideration regarding strategies for learning. Then meaningfulness is also an important factor in learning process. So the strategies selected shall be meaningful in nature. So our aim is to develop the individual learner as a whole, all capacities of learner. So the strategies shall be meaningful in nature. Then community is an integral aspect of holistic education. So that togetherness, that group work. So the strategies shall be for a group, for an individual, as well as for the society. There shall be provision for working together. So that togetherness is another aspect of strategies according to holistic approach. So the strategies shall be transformative, integrated, transdisciplinary. It should have meaningfulness, and that togetherness, that community nature shall be there for strategies. Then the teacher, the role of the teacher and what a teacher should do, or how a teacher behave in a holistic class, that's very important. Teacher is less as person of authority. So a teacher is not an authority who leads and controls, but rather than seen as a friend, a mentor, a facilitator, or an experienced traveling companion. So that's about the personality of teacher or the role of the teacher, not as a controller of activities in and out of the classroom, but as a friend, a mentor, a facilitator, or an experienced traveling companion. So when we take students out of the class, a teacher is a companion, or when we enable learners to new horizons of learning, teacher as an experienced person who walk along the way an earlier time, so having so much experience. So that should be the nature of a teacher. So teacher and students, there shall be an opportunity of mutual interrelation without any boundaries, without any condition and controls. Open and honest communication is expected, and differences between people are respected and appreciated. So that's another nature of a holistic teacher. What the teacher ensure, that teacher should ensure open communication. open and honest communication. So children should not fear to respond, to approach to a teacher. So always there shall be open and honest remarks are welcomed by a holistic teacher or a holistic classroom, and differences between people should be respected and appreciated. Naturally, all individuals are unique, so that uniqueness of individuals result in differences of opinions. So such differences of opinion is natural, and that should come out honestly and in open, and all such things shall be respected and valued. Cooperation is the norm rather than competition. So learning occurs through cooperation. We already seen that group work as a community together, a classroom itself considered as a community within the community, within the society. So naturally, cooperation is encouraged, not competition. Children should not be trained for competitive examination. That is not the purpose of education. Purpose of education is to develop the spirit of cooperation in them. So it is the responsibility of teacher, or it is the duty of teacher, to enable the facilities for developing cooperation among children. So that's about the teacher. He's a teacher as a friend, mentor, facilitator, or an experienced companion in the process of learning. So that's all about holistic approach to curriculum. So we have seen a definition, in-depth meaning, the basic assumptions regarding holistic approach to curriculum, and how the components, how to frame a curriculum for holistic education, various features of learning strategies, and the duties of a holistic teacher. So don't forget to subscribe my channel. So thanks for watching. Thank you all.